Good afternoon to all. So here we are back to this exercise 2.4. Yesterday I shared a new identity to you people. That was a plus b plus c whole square. The standard form is always equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus bc plus ca. So this was the standard result. On behalf of this, we did our question number 4. And then the question number 5, one part each I have solved for you. So I hope you are clear with this concept of applying this identity either in expanding or in doing the factorization. Suppose I am taking the factorization, that is of question number 5, second part for you today again. That is, you need to factorize 2x square plus y square plus 8z square. Minus it is 2 under root 2 xy, then it is plus 4 under root 2 yz, and finally minus 8xz. Fine. So this is the expression given to me which I need to factorize, and I know a square plus b square plus c square, then it is minus sign. I will decide at the later stage. But it is lying actually upon this form, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So I need to identify those perfect squares. So yesterday I was sharing with you that x square is the square of x, but I have to identify ki what is about 2. So 2 I told you can write as under root 2x square. So what is a is equal to? A is equal to under root 2x here. Y square itself is the square of y, so no issues about that. So this is now b. So value of b is y, a is under root 2x. C, again you can write, when that is not a perfect square, always put a sign of third there. And z square itself is the square of z, and that's all. So now I am getting what is a, what is b, and what is c. So that I have to substitute there, so comfortably I will be reaching either in the form of a plus b plus c whole square or plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. From there, which of these will be consisting of the negative sign, because you can see there two negatives are there. So that I have to decide afterward. So first of all, when you are doing the factorization, your first duty is to identify what is a, what is b, and what is c. Because my answer will be either in the form of a plus b plus c, if I am speaking from the standard result point of view. I have to put negative sign out of these three. Where I need to put that I will decide within these, wherever the negative signs are there, whether x is positive or y is negative or your z is negative or x is positive, that I have to see. Okay, let us decide. So now 8 I can put is under root, a I can put is under root 2x, b I can put as y, and under root 8 you can write also is 4 into 2 under the root, so that can be expressed as 2 under root 2z also, not an issue. So c you can put is 2 under root 2z also. So here is a, here is b, and here is c. So 2ab, 2bc, 2ca. Now let us see, then x and y, x into y is negative, so either I need to put this is negative, then my y should be positive. So if this is negative, this is positive, so minus into plus is minus, so x into y will remain minus. Understand? Now y is positive and z is also positive, so y into z, positive into positive, will remain positive, no issues. Again, x into z is negative, so x already I said is minus, so minus into plus will make it minus. And then you can see under root 2 into under root 8, that is equal to what? 16, and into 2, that is 16 is the perfect square, 4, 4 into 2 will make that 8xz. So my main task here to finish first, what is a? A is under root 2x. I said ki I will put minus sign here. So my b will also remain positive, and my this I can write is 2 under root 2z will also remain positive, and I will leave my answer here and write in minus under root 2x plus y plus 2 under root 2z and into again minus under root. So here then again you have to write the same minus, because any exponential formula you have written in power 2, you need to multiply that twice. So again, you can repeat the same. Or the second option yesterday I was discussing with you, you can put these both negative. So your answer can also be under root 2x minus y minus 2 under root 2z whole square. So that also you can expand twice. So under root 2x minus y minus either this or this. If x is negative, then these two will remain positive. Why? Because you can cross check y into z. So plus into plus will remain plus. X into y minus into plus will make it minus. And again minus into plus will make it minus. So xz is minus, xy is minus, yz plus into plus will remain plus. So you can check in cross, but in factorization, you have to check which are the three perfect squares there. If the number is not a perfect square, please put that in served form and take the whole square of that. So that is the out of box thinking you need to apply in this particular question. So that's all about your this identity. A plus b plus c whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2 into ab plus bc plus ca. So today, two more, that is your a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. One is this. One with minus sign, a minus b whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. These are the standard forms. One is in plus. Whenever the binomials are there, I can study with the negative sign also. But in case of trinomial, that will be a multi-optional type. So I told ki better to work out within the positive signs only. What we did in yesterday's identity, that was a plus b plus c whole square. So here the binomials are there. So one I can take in plus, one I can take in minus. So my a plus b whole cube will be cube of a plus cube of b plus 3ab into a plus b. Or if you will expand this also, this result finally you can write ki a plus b whole cube I can write is a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. All four. So when you will be expanding a plus b whole cube, resulting terms will be 4 and all 4 will be carrying the positive sign. So you just try to remember this. These are the basic concepts which you need to learn at the initial stage while I am explaining these things to you. So whenever you are speaking about the a plus b whole cube, the result will always be 4 terms. And 4 terms with all 4 positive signs. And then what is going to happen there in minus 1? Now you see, this is a cube, this is minus b cube, minus into plus is minus 3a square b, and minus into minus is plus 3ab square. So no chance of any confusion you have to leave anywhere. From the learning point of view, do not try to cram the things. Please try to understand. Try to understand. Understanding is very, very important here. So a minus b whole cube is a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b minus into plus. From here I am getting only. So again the resulting expanded form is 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms are there. 4 are here, 4 are here. In positive, all 4 are consisting of positive signs. And in negative 1, 2 are positive and 2 are negative. So that is the key idea which we can carry or we can apply in our questions. Especially in case of factorization. Suppose I am picking one question, that is number factorize. 8th question suppose I am taking. 8th question I will be taking. Any part suppose I am taking. I am taking the first part. 8th question, first part, and I will come back to these two identities from the factorization point of view, not from the expansion point of view, from the factorization point of view, because question number 8 is factorize. First part is 8a cube plus b cube plus 12a square b, and then it is 6ab square. Count the terms 1, 2, 3, 4. Then all 4 are positive. Out of these 4, 2 definitely will be the perfect cubes. You see here a and b. And which two are the perfect cubes? So one of them will be A and another will be B. So here you can see this is the cube of 2a is a perfect cube, and this is the cube of b. So this is a and this is b. Nothing I have to do. Simply I can leave my answer here by identifying a and b only, 2a plus b whole cube. And if you expand that, so 2a plus b into 2a plus b into 2a plus b, 3 times, that will be the factor for this expansion, because this is the perfect cube of what? 2a plus b whole cube. So if I will expand that, a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b, you can see here 3a square b, 3a square is what? 4a square, 3 4s are what? 12, 12a square into b, that is 12a square b. Similarly, 3ab square is there, so 3ab, what is a? Is 2a, 3 into 2a is 6a, and what is b? Is b, so b square will be there. So like that you can try these, so very simple. And if you go to the suppose I am taking the another part there, with the fourth part, suppose I am taking of the same eighth question, fourth part. So your fourth part is, here it is, 64a cube. Again you have to factorize, minus 27b cube, and then it is minus 144a square b, and then it is plus 108ab square. Again you see how many terms are there. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 terms are there. So in case of a minus b whole cube, 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. Out of 4, 2 are positive, 1 and 2. And 2 are negative, so that is 1 and 2. Again, out of these 4, 2 are the perfect cubes which you can identify. 1 is a and 1 is b, so then this will be the cube of what? A minus b. So what is a? You know, 64 is a perfect cube of 4, a is the cube of a, 27 is of 3, b is of b, and this is a and this is b. So a is 4a and b is 3b. So finally you are left with what? 4a minus 3b whole cube. 4a minus 3b whole cube. So 4a minus 3b whole cube, when you will expand, so that will be equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square. So you can substitute here, 4a cube will give you 64a cube, 3b cube will give you 27, and then it is 3a square b. A square means what? 16a square into 3, 48, and 48 into 3 will make it 144, a square into b. And similarly 3ab square, 3 4s are 12a, b square means 9b square, so 12a into 9b square will make it 108ab square. You need not to worry about this expanded form, but then still you can cross check at last whether what I did is correct or not. Otherwise, out of these 4, you have to identify which are the 2 perfect cubes. If all 4 are positive, then that is always a plus b whole cube. And if 2 are positive and 2 are negative, then a minus b. But please identify very carefully what is a and what is b. So then you write your answer in terms of a plus b whole cube or a minus b whole cube. So that's all about your factorization. If you are speaking from the expansion point of view, so expansion point of view, there are 2 questions given to you. You can work out within the plus or the minus sign here. 6th and 7th. In 6th and 7th, when it is suppose you have 2a minus 3b whole cube, you have to expand. So I don't think any difficulty should be there. You are belonging to this one where a is 2a. So you write the result. A cube minus b cube minus 3a square means 2a square, a is 2a, into b means 3b, and then plus 3ab square, so 3 into, 3 is already written, 3 into 2a square, 3, sorry, ab square, b is 3b square. So that's all. Now you can write the answer here. 2a cube means 8a cube, that is minus 27b cube minus 3. So then again this will be minus 3 into 4a square into 3b, and then here it is plus 3 into 2a into 9b square. So then it comes 8a cube minus 27b cube minus 3 4s are 12, 3s are 36a square b, and plus it is 3 2s are 6, 9s are 54 AB square. So here you can leave your answer. So again, the resulting answer is in 4 terms. Out of that, 2 are positive and 2 are negative, which is the result of your A minus B whole cube. Similarly, you can work out for the plus 1 also. And then in 7th question that you did in class 8, in terms of A plus B whole square or A minus B whole square, like I will be giving you the example of 99 whole cube. So you can express it in what? 100 minus 1 whole cube. So A minus B whole cube. If it is 102 whole cube, the next part, then you have to write that is 100 plus 2 whole cube. So that is A plus B. A is 100, B is 1. A is 100, B is 2. And apply these two identities and check the answers. So that's all about your identity of A plus B whole cube and A minus B whole cube. So that is there from this exercise point of view. Remaining identities I will be sharing in next class. Thank you.